Good day to you, gentlemen. You have learned how to integrate x to the power of n. And let me quickly recall, this will give us x to the power of n plus 1 divided by the new power n plus 1 and the constant, arbitrary constant c. So now let us look at more complex, slightly more complex expression where x is no longer x, but it is now ax plus b to the power of n. Ax plus b to the power of n. Let me quickly look at this word example to explain to you what the rule is. So we have y is equals to 3x plus 2 to the power of 5. First, we have to find dy dx. Okay, so let us quickly recall what is the differentiation of y, where y is 3x to the power of 5. Okay, here we go. Y is 3x plus 2 to the power of 5. So now dy dx, we have bring down power reduced by 1, and I need to times the differentiation of 3x plus 2, which is 3. So now we have 15 3x plus 2 to the power of 4. And hence, we can determine the integration of 3x plus 2 to the power of 4. So we have learned that integration is the reverse process. Reverse process of differentiation. So now we are going to look at the integration by understanding that integration is the reverse process of differentiation. So I'm going to use this result and write that the integration of 15 3x plus 2 to the power of 4 with respect to x is going to give me my initial question expression 3x plus 2 to the power of 5 plus c. So with that, let us work our way to the aim of integrating 3x plus 2 to the power of 4. Okay, we have also learned that when we integrate k, where k is a function, I mean where k is a constant, integrate k times function fx, I can pull out my constant and just integrate my fx. So here, my constant is 15. I am going to pull out 15. Oops, what did I do? I am going to pull out 15. And I can integrate 3x plus 2 to the power of 4, which will still give me the same result. And now I am going to divide by 15 throughout to get my aim of integrating 3x plus 2 to the power of 4. So I divide by 15 throughout. This will be the 15. And c divide by 15 is still a constant. Wow, I like this word, arbitrary. Arbitrary constant c means it can be any random constant value. So c divided by 15, it's still a c because it can be any constant. So we can now look at 3x plus 2 power 5 divided by 15. If I break 15 up into the product of 3 and 5, my apologies, I want to write 5 in front. I want to write 5 in front. It makes my explanation easier. Can you see that 5 is my new power? New power over here. And my 3 is the differentiation of the function 3x plus 2. Ta-da! That's the rule. Okay, write down two observations. Number one, when we integrate, we definitely need to increase the power by 1. Increase power by 1. And then, number 2, we are to divide the expression by the new power. In this case, it is 5. And then also divide by the differentiation, let me write in words, short form, differentiation of the AX plus B. Okay, now let's do a quick check. Let's do a quick check to see if we differentiate this, will we get back my question. Check. Differentiate. This is my 3x plus 2 to the power of 5 whole thing over 15 plus c, and I can now apply my differentiation chain rule. Bring down, okay, what, this is 1 over 15, I leave it as 1 over 15, okay. Bring down power reduced by 1 times the differentiation of 3x plus 2, which is 3, and you differentiate the c, you get 0. So now can you see that the 15 and the numerator can be cancelled with the 15 and the denominator, and we are going to get back 3x plus 2 to the power of 4. So now do you understand why I need to divide by the new power as well as the differentiation of the function? There you go, because of chain rule, yeah? So here, this is the formula. When you need to integrate this, you need to divide by the new power as well as the differentiation of AX plus B, which is A. Okay, let's move on. Mrs. Liao is going to ask you to do the next page. So slow. Do this next page by yourself after I go through harder questions. Try it yourself. If you can get the answers provided by the notes, then you don't have to watch the video, which I'm going to use another video to record this page. So now quickly, let's go to page 10. Go to page 11. Oh my goodness, so slow. Okay, here we go. Page 11 consists of harder questions. If I teach you harder questions and you can understand, then you have no problem doing the easier ones. Am I right? Now let us look at 2A. 2A is about integrating. So let us write the symbol. The symbol is actually the capital big S, S for summation, where you put everything together, which is the opposite of differentiation, where you break things down. So summation is putting things together, okay? So I can, like what I've said just now, pull out the constant, and then I integrate my 5x minus 6 to the power of 4, and this will give me, let us apply what we have learnt. We have to increase the power by 1, which is 5, divided by new power 5, and the differentiation of 5x minus 6, which is 5, and not forgetting our constant c. So this is straightforward, yes. So this is your answer. Don't copy wrongly. If you copy wrongly, then you don't get your accuracy mark in the end. And we are done with part A. Okay, part B. Where's my cursor? Okay, part B. Part B. Let us write my power such that it is a value I can work with easily. My summation sign, right, nicer. I like it this way. Now it looks better. Okay, now we have to look at the Integration, I have 2x plus 7 power increased by 1. This will be 5 over 2 divide by new power 5 over 2 times the differentiation of this function, which is 2. Don't forget your c, okay? Okay, here we have to deal with the cancellation. Denominator, these 2 and these 2 can be cancelled. So this will give me my 2x plus 7 power 5 over 2 and whole thing divided by 5 plus c. I'm done. Now, part c. Okay, here, what can I write? This means 2 minus 7x to the power of half, right? But because this is the denominator, I need to use my negative index to indicate that this is negative half. For the power is negative half. Alright, so now we can go and integrate, leaving out the constant 5, I integrate the expression. Power increased by 1, negative half plus 1 is half, divide by new power times differentiation of this, not 2, oh, it is negative 7. If it's negative 7, then I am going to get okay, here I must explain to you. Okay, let's do it this way. Sorry, I am going to write this, and this is going to be negative 7 over 2. Negative 7 over 2, and then I hope you are good with your fractions. This 2, you can simply flip it up to join with the 5. Why? Later explain. Okay, now I quickly write down the answer for you. First, this is going to be a negative 10, because this is a negative here, right? 2 minus 7x to the power of half divide by 7 plus c. Okay, now Mrs. Leo explain this part. This part is because when you have looking at 5 divided by negative 7 over 2, my primary school teacher says, I change. I do this way easier for you all to see. 5 over negative 7 over 2, your primary school teacher said that this one is 5 divided by, 5 divided by negative 7 over 2. This one can change to times, right? And then here we have negative 10 over 7. Shortcut is what? Shortcut is take this 2. You can go and flip it up to join 5 to get your 10. Okay? Pause. Okay, now let's go on to part D. Part D is the integration of 3. And we have, what do you think the power is? Now that you are better at this type of questions already. Yes, the power is negative 3 over 2. And we now integrate 5 minus 4x to the power of, increased by 1, okay? This is negative half divided by negative half times negative 4. So pupils who are weak will think that this is negative 5 over 2. Please don't be careless. This one you must think carefully, okay? And then I don't forget my plus c. Yes, cancellation. This and this, goodbye. Minus, minus, goodbye. This one is 2. So I have now 3. This one negative power. Let me go and put it at the denominator. 2. I can write square root. If you don't want to write square root, also can. You can also write the power half at the denominator. Now let's quickly go on to E, because I want to quickly finish, then you don't have to spend so much time watching me. Okay, this is 2 to the power of 4. Don't forget the power 4 must go to the 2 as well as 3x minus 1, but because this is at the denominator, now the power should be negative. Okay, 2 to the power of 4 is, you're right, 16. then now I integrate this part. I integrate this part after pulling my constant out. So I'm going to get 3x minus 1 to the power of negative 3. Now you got it. Plus 1. It is negative 3 times negative 3. And this is 3, not forgetting my c. And then I get negative 16. This one is denominator, okay? So 9 is down at the denominator, and this is 3x minus 1 to the power of 3 plus c. Aha, one more. Part f is about integration of the 3 quarters. I am going to take 3 quarters as the constant, okay? That easier to do. Then you have 5 minus 2x to the power of what? Negative 3, and you are right. So now I am going to leave out my constant outside. Okay, so what do you think the power is? Increase by 1, huh? Negative 2. And then I have new power times differentiation of the function. There you go, plus C. Oh, my son just woke up. 不要吵啊. 3 quarter. Ah, what is this? Aiyah, Mrs. Liao, forget to get ready my fraction because my son came in. Okay, 3, this one is the 4 times the 4, and then this one is my negative power, so it goes down to the denominator. We have 3 over 16, and we are going to finish. Yes, done. Okay, now you can try the previous page, okay? See you in a while if you need my explanation. If not, I will talk to you next lesson.